And so it will be an offensive zone draw. UNH changed up. BC keeps the same unit out there. 20 seconds to go on the original matching penalties. Kirby has it. He fires a shot. Gloves it. Rebound. Score! Ben Smith bats it out of the air. A power play goal. And it's a 2-1 game. We'll see just how high the stick was when he batted it in.
Kirby just gets a shot. Looks like Smith makes a good play right there. He sees it coming down. It looks like he actually waited a little bit for it to come down. He swats it out of the air into the net. You know, Coach York told Sonny on that interview at the beginning of the game, they practiced a lot of their special teams. Right here, they allow to get a power play, especially a 4-on-3, and Smith makes a nice play right there to get to the rebound and put it in the net.
That'll be his 20th goal of the season for Ben Smith. Second on the team in goals, third in points. They will go upstairs and quickly say it is a goal. And you're right. Looked like he actually had the presence of mind to wait for that puck to come down. As we take another look at it, I don't think there's any question. That's a good goal.
Oh, it's definitely a good goal. Good play by Smith, because he did see the puck high in the air, waited for it to come right down. Good hand-eye coordination as well to be able to knock it right out of the air and get his 20th goal. Good milestone for him, 20th goal of the year. Suffered because the forwards aren't really prepared to play that 2-on-1.
5-on-3 power play here as Whitney has it on the left side. Here's that top power play unit. The five forwards as Whitney gets it. Slides it over to the left. Plenty of time here. 40 seconds on the first penalty. Kirby has it down low and he slides it through. Bertram was there, but it got in ahead of him. Shove to the right side. Score! Whitney gets one back. And a 5-on-3 goal makes it 4-2.
Well, beautiful shot by Whitney. Nice play by Ferriero to corral it and see how Whitney is pumped, ready for the one-timer. Wastes no time. Just beats Kevin Reagan to the glove side. Kevin read it the right way. Just couldn't get over there in time. Perfectly placed shot by Whitney. You see him with that power play go. You see Ferriero right here. Perfectly placed shot by Whitney. Far side. Reagan just can't get over in time in lacrosse is hockey, except you're on feet. But one thing you get, you have a license to hack when you're in lacrosse.
There's Nathan Kirby taking it down low to the doorstep as he does so well. Save big rebound, loose in front, scramble for it, score! On a third effort, Brian Gibbons bats it in. We got a one-goal game.
Well, this is just, number one, it's a big goal for Boston College, but they didn't give up on this play. Kirby takes it right to the net. Gibbons gets the original rebound. Smith's hacking at it. Gibbons makes a beautiful play to stick with it again. Knocking it out. You see Kirby come right out. Smith fighting. Gibbons sticks with it. Knocks it right out of the air again into the net on Kevin Reagan. You know, we said at the open, they need to get pucks in front of Reagan. They did so here, and Gibbons ends up getting the goal.
And again, they go upstairs quickly, and again, it is a goal. 12th of the season for Brian Gibbons. Clearly, the scouting report on Reagan was get it up about 5 feet high and bat it down. That's the only way to beat the player of the year. Start off the ice. Giveaway there almost led to an opportunity. Price just able to keep it in. Price with the backhand in front, score!
That looked like it was Mike Brennan that went to the net on that play, TC. And I believe it went off the skate. You see a good play by Price to keep it in right here. Price keeps it in. No, it was Dan Bertram who went to the net. Price gets it at the net. That went off Bertram's skate, I believe. May went off his stick at the end, but you see the puck go to the net, skate, off the post, and in.
Skate, left post, right post, nothing but net. Just like they drew it up, Bertram will get the credit on that goal at 4:53. They are reviewing the goal. The question will be, was there an intentional redirect of the skate? Didn't look like it from this vantage.
No, this looks like, you know, on film it should be a goal. Bertram was just going to the net, didn't know where the puck was coming from either, and that just deflected off his skate into the net. So we'll see what they have to say.
And the phone call coming down to this ice level. Now it's a goal. It stands. As you see, the official announcement, I think that's a good call, because I think if there was a movement of the foot, it was not intended to kick it in. He was skating to the net. Kirby had the overtime goal against Boston University. Here's Ferriero coming out after it. Paulo Green scores! Matt Green, the Hockey East defensive forward of the year. BC in the championship game.
Well, I don't know yet, DC. We're going over to the board there. Kevin Regan is complaining, but it looks like Ferriero's just going for the puck. He can't stop what he does with the puck, but it looks like we may get a review here. You're going to see the play come out. Sleep throws it off the boards, and Ferriero in the neutral zone sees a rolling puck. He comes in. He's just going for the puck. You know, they can't fault him in that. Green follows it up and puts it into the open cage. I mean, Ferriero just does a good job of trying to bust to get that puck. The end result is Green has an open net.
The goal stands. Oh, no, they're reviewing. I got a motion up here. Sorry, beg your pardon. Misreading the hand communication from the staff. They are going upstairs for the review, as you said, Tim.
Yeah, I just don't see how they can call this not a goal because, I mean, Regan's out of his net to get the puck. Ferriero's trying to get the puck. In no way did he try to run over the goaltender. Comes out to Green, and Green has the wide open net.
The officials have put their helmets back on. He started the skate away, and now he comes out. No goal is the official call. No goal. So the call is no goal. They made some announcement. I don't think we caught it up here over the PA. The call is the goalie's helmet was off when the shot was taken. And so apparently they're making the call that you don't need the whistle in that case. It's automatically dead. That's 55 seconds remaining on the penalty to Danny Dries. The interference call at 18:55 of the second overtime. So Boston College with the power play fired up with the extra man on with the puck behind its own net. BC Eagles get it started on the ice. Here comes Gerby. Nathan Gerby flipping it ahead on the left side. Greg Collins getting there. Brings it out in front. 30 seconds remaining on the power play as the Eagles get it back. Trying to quickly convert an opportunity here with the advantage numbers-wise. They get it back to Gerby, back to the point. Gerby flips it over to the left side. They work it around to Whitney up top. At the point. Shot comes loose, score! The shot came to the point. Ben Smith was out in front. Boston College wins the longest semifinal in Hockey East history.
Well, it looked like Ferriero took the original shot and hit something on the way through it. It even might have went off the UNH defender. We're gonna get a look at it right here. See Burton go to the point to Whitney, over to Ferriero. Ferriero takes the shot. I believe that went off number four, Switzer, and over the shoulder. Yeah, it went off Switzer, then over the glove of Kevin Regan right there. And that's going to be a Benn Ferriero goal off Switzer, right over the, off the post, actually, and over the shoulder of Kevin Regan.
Boston College defeats the University of New Hampshire, keeping its record with four or more goals. Perfect at 19-0.